Ladies and gentlemen, welcome.
Bienvenue à Animagique pour notre conférence. Sans plus attendre, merci d'accueillir.
Please welcome our master of ceremony, Charlie.
I'm Charlie and I'm delighted to be with you guys tonight. Je suis ravie d'être parmi vous ce soir, and even more because tonight we have the true honor and pleasure to welcome on the stage a very special guest. At the head of Disneyland Paris, she inspires more than 16,000 cast members to deliver a unique and unforgettable experience to our guests every day. She will very soon take new responsibilities overseas, adding Disneyland Resort and the Walt Disney World Resort to her scope. And you know what? She really insisted on meeting you guys tonight. So why don't you help me in giving a warm welcome to our president, Mrs. Catherine Powell. For you, obviously, my first one is, Catherine, can you tell us more about your Disney career before Disneyland Paris?
So I've been at Disney, working for Disney for 14 years now. This June will be 14 years. And I started, before I joined Disney, my first job was an assistant to a journalist who did news programs in war zones. So I filmed news programs in Somalia, in Sudan, in Ethiopia. Never could I have imagined 35 or 30 years ago that I'm not 35 actually, I'm not that old. 20 years ago, that 20 years later, 25, I'd be wearing Mickey ears and living in the most beautiful park in the world. So it's incredible. So I started doing that, worked for the BBC a bit, and then joined Disney selling Disney's programs and Disney's channels to TV channels and stations around the world. And then in 2014, I went to Australia for 2 years with my family and ran all of Disney's businesses, so consumer products, feature film releases, ESPN, websites, theatrical stage shows. And then in 2016, I was invited to come here. So that was my short story. How I got to Disneyland Paris.
Back into your childhood, what is your first memory as a child about Disney?
Well, when I was about, when I was about six, I asked, or maybe five, I asked my parents to rename me Aurora. So that was, I don't know why, but it was Aurora, they refused. And then my second memory, which must have been shortly after that, I wrote to Father Christmas. So I must be about seven or eight, and I asked him for a pair of glass slippers. And the next morning, imagine my disappointment when Father Christmas said the glass factory was closed. So I never had my glass slippers, but actually, you can see behind me, I did get a glass slipper from the release of Cinderella, the movie that was, would be released that in Australia. But those are my two earliest memories.
Everyone has been really excited about the 25th anniversary here at Disneyland Paris. What's your best memory about it?
That was, I don't know how many of you were here on the 25th, on the 12th of April. Yes. Oh my God, I mean, that was just incredible. The sun shined like it is today, which was so great, because April's not necessarily known for its sunny days. The park looked beautiful, absolutely beautiful. We've done all the work to get it ready. We had the grand celebration in the morning, and then we had my favorite bit, which was the cast member flash mob, which was just fantastic. It was a very, very, very special moment. I did any cast members are here, it was the day that I had my chair de poulet.
Maybe we will give you again this show in the pool, because I think we have the video right in the booth. Should we take a look at it?
On est trop surexcités, on a en prépare ça depuis déjà plusieurs semaines. On est cheap seul, vraiment jusqu'à hier soir très tard. On avait vraiment envie d'être là ce matin, ça s'est super bien passé. On est frissons, quoi. Il fait beau, c'est magnifique. La journée de nos buckets magiques, voilà, c'est les 25 ans, donc on a vraiment hâte d'y être.
Après la
Happy birthday et merci, merci du profond de ma cœur. C'était une journée incroyable pour moi. J'étais tellement émue. I'm honored to be with you. Have a wonderful day.
Bah, c'était super, c'était une super aventure, une super expérience. Vraiment une super bonne ambiance, génial, fantastique. C'était. Ouais, c'était bien.
C'était extra!
Génial! On est allé au 25e an, trop fier de travailler!
Et comme il dit ma copine, franchement, il boit que
génial!
Quel génial!
La plaque est fantastique!
De la joie, c'est génial! Il fait beau en plus, on a de la chance! Et voilà, c'est un moment qui va être marqué, comme pour le 20e j'étais là et je ne sais pas quoi d'être là pour le 25e.
On avait envie de pleurer, on était excités! C'est génial, c'est une aventure à vivre, franchement, génial!
Some of the YouTube videos of our guests from tiny, tiny ages to adults clearly here tonight who learned the choreography. Exactly. And it was just incredible. And to see the little princesses who joined their idols do the choreography with them, that really caught the imagination of our fans and the cast members, I have to say. And the final battle a couple of days ago was wonderful. So that's a new season. And then the Summer of Superheroes, which launches in a few days, our Marvel event, which is, we've got a fantastic show that the team are working on for that. And what we're really trying to do is introduce more seasons and events like Fan Days. I mean, Fan Days is a first. We've never done anything like this. No park has done something like this before. We're trying to do more events, a bit like Electro Man that we did last year that we'll do again. We have our fun runs, our Disney runs. and we're doing more the seasons like the food and wine. So we're trying to, throughout the year, create experiences for you that are diverse, that appeal to lots of different interests, and basically keep a beat of product, if you like, a beat of experiences throughout the year. So yes, it's something that the team are very, very focused on, and it's part of the history of DLP. We haven't, Disneyland Paris, we haven't had the investment that the other parks have had, and so we've really had to lean into entertainment, and I think you'll all agree that the entertainment here, our parades, our costumes, are some of the most beautiful of all the parks, and so it's great to be able to do even more with that.
Are we allowed to tell them about the Lion King bat too?
There's the Lion King. I'm always worried because I'm terrible at, I've got my comms here, I'm terrible at sharing things prematurely. So if you've said it, I'm guessing it's okay.
Yes.
We've got our Lion King next year, which will be unbelievable. That film is going to be fantastic. So that's a very special season. So we're continuing, I mean, Season of the Force, which was new, will come back. We're continually trying to do new things. And we've had lots of requests for Princess and Pirates to come back.
Woo!
We definitely want that to come back.
Yeah!
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 Woo!
Definitely. Yes, definitely.
So, who's your favorite character then?
Not Aurora, despite my desire to have a name. Tinkerbell.
Tinkerbell. Why?
Because just look at her. She's just like, you know, what's not to like?
Walt Disney was an incredible visionary with a philosophy that still guides us. How did he inspire you in your work here in Disneyland Paris?
Well, he's Walt Disney, and there are going to be so many of you in the room who know so much more about him than I do, because our fans are experts, so I defer to your knowledge and your expertise. But he was an incredible visionary. I mean, if you think of what he's achieved and the legacy that has given the company, from the first synchronized cartoon with Steamboat Willie, the first animated film with Snow White, and if you look now, we own Pixar, which created the first computer-generated film with Toy Story. Lucasfilm, which is also part of Disney, has ILM, Industrial Light and Magic, and any film that any of you have seen and loved, apart from a Disney film, will have ILM effects. They are world-class, world-leading in effects. So this legacy of innovation and technology and creativity is Walt's. And he was talking about driverless cars and GPS back in the 50s. He created the Walt Disney Imagineers, I think in 1952. And so he had this vision that these people with incredible talent and imagination, you have one in the front row tonight, star Tom Fitzgerald. Business and being able to work with these geniuses is incredible, and that was Walt. But Walt also had a philosophy about life and about how one should live, and he talks about curiosity. He talks about, you know, curiosity taking you down new paths. He talked about the fact that Disneyland would never be completed so long as there's imagination in the world, and you see that with the parks, with the development that is ongoing. And he talked about people a lot. He said, you know, you can have these amazing ideas, but it's people who make them happen. And I think for my inspiration, for what I have tried to sort of inspire in the cast members, is just this be curious and think differently, dare to think differently and take risks that we will support you on.
Bob Iger, CEO of the Walt Disney Company. He recently met the French president, Mr. Macron, at l'Elysée to announce a historical investment. And in fact, Macron even referenced Disney in a speech in VivaTech. So could you tell us more about this multi-year expansion plan? Could you?
So can we go back to that photo a second?
Oh.
I just want to point out where I was sitting. I those knees are Bob Chapek's knees, and I'm about here. I was that close to President Macron. Who spoke perfect English, perfect English. He was very, very impressive. No, that was, I mean, I have been so lucky with my time at at Disneyland Paris, do you think that I started at a very difficult moment in July in 2016, which, as many of you will remember, was I started 2 days before Nice, the Nice attack, and saw the business just disappear. It was awful, and morale, I mean, generally in France was pretty low, but it was terrible. And we just, you know, what Disneyland Paris and the cast members and fans who keep us going did best to sort of just carry on, get ready for the 25th, and it just all came together after the 25th. We had the 25th, then Disney took us private, which was also a big moment for Disneyland Paris and meant that we could have this incredible investment. So if we now go, we can now remove Bob Chapek's knees from shot, and there you see this artistic vision, incredible. Mr. Tom Fitzgerald, sitting in the front row, has been part of pulling this creative vision together, and it's so exciting to have this. We'll have the lake as our sort of focal point, and we'll have our lands, have Star Wars Land and Frozen, and obviously Marvel Land, which has already been announced. We'll do that. So it's going to be incredibly, incredibly exciting. It will be pretty disruptive for the Walt Disney Studios. Those of you who remember the work that we did in preparation for the 25th, there are lots of closures as we try to make everything look absolutely beautiful. And the Walt Disney Studios, there'll be even more. So we very much want to make sure that we take you, our fans, on the journey with us, show you the excitement as we develop things, and share with you as we can reveal new things, because it will be a really, really exciting journey.
We're excited too, right?
Yeah!
Catherine, what's a typical day of work for you? What does it look like?
Well, no day. No day is the same, except that every day is just full of meetings. There's meetings. So my day starts, I guess I get in about 8:30. It starts with me making a proper pot of coffee. I eat a pot. Not these little, that everyone in the office drinks, these little tiny things like that.
Ristretto?
Yes, that's not, you know, coffee, you need a proper plunger and you put it in a mug and you add milk and it's start your day that way. So I start with that. I have to change gear because I'll go from a meeting with the finance team perhaps on what the quarterly numbers look like, and then I'll have a meeting on last week's attendance or the weekend's attendance and how that looks and which territories are coming and how that's doing. And then I might have a meeting on the plans for the new Hotel New York, which is exciting. The creative meetings are incredibly interesting. It's fantastic to do that. I've had meetings where I've seen a typical day could be then a meeting to see a rehearsal for the new Marvel show, for example. Then I might be meeting public partners, the préfet or the maire de Paris, or at Paris, where we're talking about working together, or we might be talking about security, or we might be talking about the new extension. And then I will, at about 5 o'clock, start having calls with the US, or conference calls, or VTCs, where we share creative. So it can often be a long day, but it's so interesting. I mean, no day is the same, and every meeting is incredibly interesting. I'll do a lot also try to get to the park, to see things in the park, or to meet cast members. We have showtime, where I can dress up and do one of the jobs that the cast members do. So I had a time at the Hyperion Videopolis, at the quick service restaurant, and I have to say, I was not quick. I have so much respect now, people who can do all these things with, you know, remembering tomato ketchup and mustard and Coke and ice, and oh my gosh, it's very, very stressful. But I'll try and do things like that to understand. So no, it's very, very varied, which is what makes the job so amazing.
So you will soon have new responsibilities too, overseas with the Western region, in which you will oversee, so the Walt Disney World Resort, Disneyland Resort, and Disneyland Paris. So that's a lot. How do you feel about it?
In awe. it's an incredible, it's so exciting. I feel every emotion, honestly. At the moment, I feel every emotion. Incredible honor to be doing it. Incredibly excited. Incredibly emotional about leaving, moving from here. I mean, Disneyland Paris was my first park love, so we'll always have a special place. And I'm still obviously going to be connected, but we're moving, so it's a big deal. But I think for me to be able to have the view of all three parks and the domestic in particular, and see what we can leverage for Disneyland Paris. I mean, Disneyland Paris has for so long been on its own, doing stuff with its own budgets, and you know what it can do with the challenges that they've had, particularly because we weren't part of the Walt Disney Company. Now we can see where there are synergies and opportunities. You could see things like when we opened or we announced our Marvel Land, we announced Marvel Land in Hong Kong and also at Disneyland, and we're looking, you know, you can see that, you will know that Ratatouille is going to Epcot. So I think there'll be many, many opportunities for more synergies like that.
Is this how they actually learn from and inspire each other, all the parks?
Yes, they do. I mean, there's each park has a distinct nature. And as I said, I've got Tom sitting there, and he'll be able to speak to this far better than I can. But there is something that is authentically Disney. Bob Iger, when he talked about Shanghai Disneyland, talked about it being authentically Disney but distinctly Chinese. And when you look across the parks, even parks that are as similar as Disneyland Resort and Disneyland Paris, they have their own identities. And what we've done, we talked about the seasons earlier, we've done a lot here to try to give Disneyland Paris its own identity and something that appeals to our European and our French guests. And so the parks are different. If you look at World, each of the lands has its own DNA. So there's a lot that's different, but there's a lot that's the same. So it's going to be very exciting. But I do think that there'll be a lot that can be shared, and having that overview will make it much easier.
That makes me want to show you a little trailer, and I think we're all going to have the share the poulet again. Roll it.
All around the world, every single day, we set out to make magic. On land and at sea, in destinations around the globe, all with one goal in mind, to welcome our guests. Amazing journey. Over 2.5 billion people have traveled along with us. And yet, after all these unforgettable moments, we're just getting started.
Which one would it be? What's your favorite one?
Well, my favorite one was partly it's my favorite because it was the first one I went on. Pete, I'm going to say, it was the first one I went on, and it also has Tinkerbell, so it's Peter Pan. And also it has London, and I'm British. So I absolutely love that attraction. And it was one of the first ones that it was redone in preparation for the 25th, and it was so beautiful. I remember going over it the first time and just took my breath away. There's a picture, I love it. And I still love it every time I go on it, I love it.
What will you miss the most about Disneyland Paris when you will be there?
The cast members, obviously, and our fans. Fans are so... There are wonderful fans and wonderful cast members in the other parks, and I'm so excited about that. But I have a very sort of special affection for our cast members and our fans here. They are amazing. I'll miss our castle, which is obviously the most beautiful of all the parks. I won't miss the grey skies or the rainy weather when the parade is called off, although it's rarely called off. I mean, it's incredible in what conditions. I remember the first time I was here, I was like, oh, well, they're not going to do that, are they, in this weather? I said, no, everyone's fine. It's incredible. It's incredible how our guests are so hardy. So I'll miss Paris as well, but I will be coming back. This isn't goodbye.
And what would you like people to remember as your main legacy here at Disneyland Paris?
Well, I hope not the chef de poulet. that's not very serious. I feel that I am a moment in time for Disneyland Paris. I've been given the sort of the honor of caretaking Disneyland Paris and the brand, and looking after it and cherishing it, and then I'll hand on to my successor at one time. So I feel like I have a role to play. So it's more, what I can contribute in that time. I hope that we started together, my time, as I said, at a very, very difficult stage. And I really hope that together with the cast members, we've managed to sort of bring more optimism and pride in what they do. It's incredible, and I think there is a real pride for where Disneyland Paris sits at the moment in Paris and France, and with the Walt Disney Company. I think we're in a very, very good place, so I'm delighted to be leaving with that.
My last question is not a question, it's actually a picture. Can we take a look at it? It's coming up. Can you explain us this story? What happened that day?
Okay, does anyone in the room know? In which case I might lie.
To you.
Was anyone in the room there?
No.
Okay.
Someone raised
his hand
over there. You were there?
Okay. So that was a month before the 25th. And it was our 30th anniversary of the main agreement with the state. And the president then, President Hollande, came to Disneyland Paris. I met him. He was charming. We went on a little tour, and then we came into one of our conference center rooms, which was enormous. And there must have been about 1,000 people sitting down, all the sort of the guard and the, all in their costumes with their uniforms, sorry, not costumes, uniforms, feathers and everything. And then this wall of media, absolutely wall, they were like 10 layers high or something. And he was very sort of chilled, so I was quite sort of relaxed about it all, even though, there was a huge fanfare of protocol. And we walk into the room, and then I'm announced as normal with my jingle, and I'm walking up on stage, so if I'm sort of, there's the stage, there's my book, I'm walking up on stage, and as I step, I was stepping and I couldn't move any further. And I was like, what's that? So I tried to step again. And my heels, not dissimilar to these, you can see I'm wearing a lace skirt. My heels were like tent pegs that had gone through the tent. And I was like this, literally like this. The President Hollande was about here. And I'm halfway up, like this. Shit. I was like, and behind me, there was this 1,000 people going, and I could hear the jingle of the uniforms as they're all jumping up to come and help me. And I was like there thinking, okay, I could die. I could pretend to die. And then it will all go away. And then, no, it's fine. So I'm telling them, c'est bon, c'est bon. And I kind of span around sat down, I had to disentangle my shoes from my skirt. And I went, c'est bon, picked up my shoes and walked. I had to walk across the whole stage to the lectern, the pulpit. And then I had to say, you know, wait a moment, put my shoes back on, stand up. And then I think I said to President Hollande, and there was I worried that something was going to go wrong. And then I had to give a speech for 12 minutes in French, in my heart, going like that. And at the end of it, when I stood up to come and I went to go down the steps again, President Hollande and his very important person with lots of feathers jumped up to help me down. So it was, oh my God, it was the most embarrassing moment of my life. And it was even more, it wasn't so much that the President of France was there, it was that my husband and three boys were in the audience, and I knew they'd be dying of embarrassment, absolutely dying of embarrassment. But President Hollande was very, very charming. He, first of all, he said, you told me that there were gonna be some surprises in your speech. You know, there certainly were. And then he told me that I'd created a new attraction. And then the cast members for a bit called me Cinderella. So that was my most embarrassing moment of my life. Yeah, so that's the story.
That was amazing though. Catherine, thank you so much for being with us tonight. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.